Titled Those From Among You, the documentary is produced by the first daughter, Natasha Museveni Karugire.
Film, first of all, just as a medium, I love film, I love, you know, dreaming, I love beauty, I love the way... Yes, I think so. I love the way things are depicted in film, and, you know, and the way things are portrayed and things like that. So I just have that, like, dreamy side of, you know.
Natasha says part of the reason she documented this NRA liberation stories and experiences from various actors is to contextualize the struggle for the young generation, especially the country's 78% youthful population.
I love to reach the young people, my children's generation, those who are, you know, in their early 30s and, you know, 20s and maybe the 18 onwards, 18 to their mid-30s. That would be wonderful. But also for my generation, my age group, who were there during the war, it's good. I think it's good to have context for ourselves, for our children of Uganda, where we are coming from.
Asked what inspired her to name the documentary Those From Among You, Natasha says the need to repair the bridge as captured in the book of Isaiah 58 verse 12 triggered her latest piece of work.
There's so much other information and there's so much distraction for this young generation. So I think if we could somehow focus on patriotism for people to, if we love our country, then we are really all stakeholders in it. You don't want it, because anything that goes wrong affects this land, which is for us.
The liberation of Uganda, Natasha says, came at a price paid by brave and determined young men and women, led by her father, President Yoweri Museveni, who hoped for a better country.
As I've mentioned before, like, I'm very close to my parents. And I've seen their service and their work ethic all through, you know, my life. So I began to feel like, why, this is such a powerful story. Why is it just not out there, you know? So that's where it all began, and it became a very heavy, like, thing on me.
To understand this struggle, Natasha dug up the Luwero Bush War story, talked to different people such as historians, former 1981 to 1986 Bush War combatants, and senior citizens.
And then I began to pursue it, and that's how 27 guns happened. And I thought that was finished. And but then I somehow again... It came up again, and then I realized, okay, now let's tell it from a different angle. Let's hear it from those who, like, not act it out, but from their own mouths, their own telling of it. So that's how now we got into this documentary.
An avid lover of art and the creative industry, Natasha, in September 2018, also launched a biopic film about President Yoweri Museveni and the NRA combatants dubbed 27 Guns. By Africans telling their own stories, Natasha says the narrative remains original and not distorted or controlled by outsiders.
Came into it is I just began to feel like our stories are not told. When our stories are told, they are told through some foreigner, most of the time, some foreigner's perspective, which might not be the right one. So that's how it all began. That's really where it all began, with me thinking that, or feeling very strongly that we need to tell our story.
In 2020, Natasha also published her autobiography titled What's in a Name, Kane Mbabazi, where she narrates her life's journey as a child, mother, and first daughter. Report by David Lumu for the news.